is said to be linear if dependent variable and its derivative occur in first degree and they are not multiplied together. For example, if I am writing d over dx plus xy is equal to 2, this is a linear differential equation. Why so? Because its dependent variable and its derivative occur in degree 1 and they are not multiplied together. So it is an example of linear differential equation. First of all, there are lots of linear differential equation, and if the question is falling in the category of linear differential equation, we have to identify first before we solve it. So we have to see the condition given in the definition. If it is fulfilling, then it is a linear differential equation, otherwise it is not. Take second example, dy over dx whole square plus xy is equal to 3. This is not linear differential equation because here y is a dependent variable and its derivative of y is of degree 2. So it is not a linear differential equation. So first identify the linear differential equation, then there is a procedure to handle linear differential equation. Now I am going to tell you how to solve linear differential equation. So let's take one question, d over dx minus 2y is equal to x. This is a linear differential equation. As I have already explained, y, dependent variable, and its derivative both are occurring in degree 1 and they are not multiplied together in the given equation. So it is a linear differential equation. If the question is of linear differential equation, then there is a one particular method to handle or to solve this equation. So let me explain you what is the working method. Step number 1. Working steps. Step number 1 to handle such kind of questions, compare the given equation with standard format form of differential equation. Standard form of differential equation is d over dx plus capital Py is equal to q. Here, capital P and capital Q are functions of x only. Functions of x only. Right? So, if I am going to compare this equation by this standard form of linear differential equation, then in this question, capital P is equal to minus 2 and capital Q is equal to x. Here, I have explained that P and Q are the function of x only. I can write minus 2 as minus 2 into e raised to power 0x. We can always write like this. So, P is a function of x, Q is already a function of x. It is given in the question. So, first condition is satisfied. Now, step number 2. First, compare the differential equation with the standard format and separate capital P and capital Q. The second is find integrating factor. Sometimes we write like integrating factor in short. So, integrating factor of differential equation is always e raised to power capital P dx. So, in our question, it will be e raised to power integral minus 2 because value of p is minus 2 dx. If we solve it, we are getting it is minus e raised to power minus 2x. So integrating factor we got is my e raised to power minus 2x. The last step is step number 3. That will be y into integrating factor is equal to integration q into integrating factor dx plus constant, and this is fixed for every kind of linear differential equation. So I'm going to put the values. Y into integrating factor is e raised to power minus 2x. This is equal to value of q is x. Integrating factor is e raised to power minus 2x dx plus constant. Now last step, I'm going to simplify it. I have to solve this integration, and I'm using the u into v formula, taking x as the first function and e raised to power minus 2x as the second function, and using by parts integration. So x as it is, integration of e raised to power minus 2x is e raised to power minus 2x over 2 minus integration. Differentiation of x is 1, and integration of e raised to power minus 2x is minus 2x over minus 2 dx plus constant. And the last step is my e raised to power minus 2x by 2 minus minus plus 1 over minus 2x. Integration is e raised to power minus 2x over minus 2 plus constant. So this is my required answer.
This is linear differential equation.